Hi guys, today's tutorial is about this amigurumi monster, and he is an amigurumified version of a drawing that my daughter did, and this is about 4 years old. I was going through my personal stuff the other night in a box full of photos and stuff, and I found this drawing, and right away as soon as I seen it, I had to amigurumify it, and I did so that very night when I found it. And this is all my notes here and how I made this guy right here. And then I went over the pattern and I made up all these other little guys here. So this tutorial is going to show you how to sew it all together. I'm going to walk you through the color changes, how to add the thumb, how to do the eyes and the mouth, the different mouth, and add the teeth and all that good stuff. So this isn't a full video tutorial like I normally do. I apologize for that. Sometime in October I'll be able to get back to my full video tutorials like I normally do. Right now time is not my own. So I think he's a cute little guy, and I hope that you enjoy the pattern. And that pattern can be found on my blog, and the link to that pattern is in the description box below. So I hope you have fun and get yourself a little monster made. And remember, if you make a monster, please post pictures on my Facebook page, Amigurumi Freely. I'd love to see. Thanks so much for watching, and have fun! Okay, I just finished row 19. I have 18 stitches around. Row 20 is where we're going to switch to the shirt color. So we're going to switch from the head to the shirt color at the top of this row here. So I just brought in my color change, and I'm just going to leave it there until I'm ready to switch colors. So row 20 calls for one single crochet in the first, and then crochet two together, and repeat all the way around to the end of the row. But we're going to switch colors on the last two together. So I'm going to go on with this row, and then I'll meet you right back here when we're ready to crochet the last two stitches together, and we'll switch colors together. Okay, I've made it all the way around, and I'm ready to put in my last two together. Just go in, grab my yarn, pull it through. Go on the next stitch, grab my yarn, pull it through. Oh, we can remove that marker. And now all I'm going to do is I'm going to hold the working yarn back here and put my finger over it to hold it. Bring in the color change, and I'm not going to do anything fancy with it. I'm just going to lay it back there and hold it under the same finger. And then get ready to crochet on with the new color. Switch fingers. Pull the new color through all three loops. And you just switch colors, and that's the end of row 20. And now we have 12 stitches around. Keep hanging on to those yarn tails because they're a little bit loose. And now row 21 is two single crochets in each one of those 12 stitches. So I'm just going to go ahead and put my, while I'm still holding onto those yarn tails, I'm going to go in the next stitch, grab my yarn, put in my single crochet, and then again, put in my second single crochet. And that was the beginning of row 21. Now I can let go. Now I'm going to put two single crochets in the rest of the stitches, and when I come back around, I will have 24 stitches in that row. So I just finished row 21, and I thought I'd just jump in and show you that you can just break free from the head color now. Just leave a little bit of a tail there. And when we're done the next row, we'll knot off those two color changes. So just leave them tucked inside. And then I'll meet you back here at the end of row 22. And then we'll knot off the yarn tails and stuff the head together. Okay, I just finished row 22, and now we have 30 stitches around, and I'm going to pull out that last stitch so I don't lose it. Just leave it hanging like that, and we're going to stuff the head. But first of all, I'm going to reach in here, and I'm going to grab those two yarn tails that where we did the color change, and we're going to knot those up. So I just do a double knot. Then you can cut them up a bit shorter and just leave them tucked inside the head. So now we're going to stuff and shape the head. You can see in this little guy here that the stuffing has been pushed into the sides. So you can see that it doesn't look like that shape right now. So what we're going to do is we're going to put lots of stuffing in there. So just start putting in your stuffing. Lots and lots goes in. Okay, so I've got lots of stuffing in here, and now I'm going to start shaping the head. And this is a little trick that I do. You can see that the head here, I've pushed stuffing into the sides. So it's elongated this way. And what I do for that is I push the stuffing in towards the last stitch that I just put in, because that's where we did a color change at the beginning. You can see here, this is where we did the color change. And then when we do the color change again, it's going to be in this area as well. So even though the color changes are going to be hard to see, there is going to be a little bit of a jump there. So what I do is I push the stuffing in towards the sides, towards that last stitch I just put in. So when I continue on later, and I sew the arms on, when you turn the doll around, you won't see any jumps in the color changes because they're all well hidden. There's one right there. That little jump there is underneath the arm. So little tricks you learn as you go along are kind of helpful because these little details make a big difference when you're doing amigurumi. Okay, so I'm just gonna put lots more in there, and now I'm pushing the stuffing to the sides, and one of those sides is where I put the last stitch in. And it takes a while. It doesn't just happen instantly when you stuff ahead. You gotta shape it as you go along. Now I'm putting some stuffing, making sure I get stuffing in this area here. So I'm just gonna use my fingers to do that. Pushing it underneath. Okay, so the head has been stuffed. You can see I have lots of stuffing in there. And now I'm going to continue out the pattern. I'll meet you back here at the end of row 26 where we switch colors again, and we'll do that part together. Okay, here I'm at the end of row 26. I'm just on the last stitch of the row 26, and I got my color change ready there. And I'm going to go into that last stitch, pull in my yarn, and then hold my working yarn back here and just put my finger over it. Then bring in my color change and hold it under the same finger. Get ready to crochet on, switch fingers, pull the new color through those two loops, and I've switched colors, and that's the end of row 26. Row 27, we're going to work in the back loops only. I'm going to show you what the front and back loops look like. So when you look at the stitch, you can see the V, and there's two loops, the front loop and the back loop. And the front loop is the one closest to you, and the back loop is the one furthest from you, and that's the one we're going to be working in. So I'll just do the first set of this row with you. Okay, I'm just going to tighten up my switching colors there. Okay, so for this row, we're going to put one single crochet in the next four stitches, then two single crochets into the fifth stitch, and then we're going to repeat that all the way around. And we're doing that in the back loops only. So going into that back loop, one single crochet in the first, second back loop, one single crochet in the second, one single crochet in the third, one in the fourth, and now two single crochets into the fifth. You see I'm working in the back loop only. And now you're just going to repeat that, one in the next four and then two into the fifth, all the way around to the end of the row. Okay, so this is the only row that you work in the back loops. When you finish this row, then you'll be back in both loops again. So I'm going to come back here at the end of row 33, and I will show you how to do the row of single crochets into that front loop there, this part right here, and we'll do that together. Okay, I just finished row 33, and now I'm going to stop, and I'm going to put that row around here for the shirt edge. So I'm just going to pull up the last stitch so I don't lose it. I'll just leave it hanging, and get your shirt color ready there, and you can see the row where we crocheted in the back loops only, there's now a ridge there, and there's loops sticking out all the way around, and we're going to crochet into those. Okay, and then you can see where the beginning of the row started and the end. There's a little bit of a jump there, so just pick one of those, push your crochet hook through, bring in your shirt color, and just pull it through. And make sure there's a little bit of a tail on the end that you can sew in later. So just pull it through. Chain one. So just yarn over and pull it through. There. And now we're going to crochet, single crochet, into every one of those loops. So just crochet into all those loops all the way around, and I'll meet you here at the end, and I'll show you how to get rid of those yarn tails. You see, I just push the body in so those loops are exposed, a little bit easier to get into that way. Okay, I'm back around to where I started, and here is where I first began, and I put a single crochet for a chain one and then a single crochet. So I'm just going to slip stitch into that first chain one there. So I'm just going to go in, grab my yarn, pull it through. And instead of yarning over, just pull it through. I'm going to break free, leave a little bit of a tail that you can work in later, and pull it tight. And now we want to bring these yarn tails inside the body. So we're just going to thread one, go right in, as close to the edge there as you can get it, and pull it through. Now the same for the next one. Go in, not the same hole that the first one's going in, go in right beside it. Because you're going to knot these together, so. Okay, and now you can knot these two off. Cut them up a bit shorter, and just leave them tucked inside. Okay, so I'll continue on now with the pattern. I'll come back here at the end of row 35 and we're going to stuff the body together. All done row 35 and now we're going to stuff the body. And now's a good time too when you're stuffing the body. You can push your hand or finger all the way in there and make sure you got all the stuffing that you need in these areas here. Just feel around there and make sure there's no gaps. And if there is gaps, fill them up. Because sometimes you get a stuffing gap right in the middle there. So just make sure you add the stuffing and then you push it all the way in. Okay, and now just stick lots of stuffing into the body. So it's kind of fat here. And then when we add the belly button, it sucks that fat in a little bit and gives them a little bit of a cute shape right here. So when you stuff the body, you can get the majority in there. What I like to do is push the stuffing into this sides here to match the head. So when I'm stuffing it, I'm going against the sides again. So one of the sides that I'm pushing against is the last stitch I just put in again. Okay, and you don't have to get it all in right now because in the next couple of rows we're going to keep stuffing. Okay, so I got lots of stuffing in there. Now when you do the next row, you're on to row 36 now. And that's one single crochet and then two together. So now that you have stuffing in there, when you're crocheting, you could pull the stuffing through the stitches. So what I do is just squeeze the body together and push the stuffing down. Use your fingers to hold the stuffing out of the way and then start crocheting. That's one and then two together. Okay, I just finished row 36 and now I'm going to put more stuffing in there. And this time I'm going to make sure that I push stuffing up in this area here. Just go around with my fingers and just shove it in there. Okay, so you can see I've made them fat in this area here. Okay, I'm going to continue on the next row. And after the next row, I'm going to do the same thing. So add my marker. And again, push the body together and hold the stuffing down out of the way. Okay, I just finished row 37 and again, before you close up this gap, you can stuff in more. And if you can't get your finger in there, then just use the back end of a pencil. Okay, so now we're going to go on to row 38 where we crochet two together and then do that twice and then we're going to finish off. If this part gives you a little bit of trouble, don't worry about it. Just finish off, leave a tail for sewing, and I'll show you how to weave in and out of the remaining stitches to close up the gap. But again, we're just going to squeeze that together, crochet two together, and this is row 38. Squeezing together. There we go. So now I'm going to break free. I'm going to leave a yarn tail for sewing and also for making the belly button. So just pull that yarn tail through that loop and pull it tight. And then thread your yarn needle. And we're just going to go in and out of these remaining stitches. So going in and then out the opposite way through the next stitch. And then in and out through the remaining stitches. Now you can pull this tight. Just make sure before you pull tight that you have all the stuffing in there that you want. And if you don't have enough stuffing, now's the time to do it. So that's pretty good. So I'm just going to pull this tight. Okay, so now I'm going to put the belly button in. I'm going to go back in and come up through the third or fourth row down from this shirt here. And I'm piercing the row. I'm not going through a stitch. I'm piercing the row. So going through the row itself. Bring the yarn tail through. And I'm just going to wrap, I'm making a French knot, so I'm just going to wrap this yarn here, this part, around the needle three times. And then I'm going to bring that needle down right beside where I came out, piercing the row again. And then back out where I went through. Pull that through. And you see the little belly button there. Now if you want to make it bigger, just go back in and do the same steps. And now hang on to it so that it doesn't go back out again. And I'm going to pick a stitch here, right close by, pull the yarn through, but before you pull it all the way through, go through that loop and then knot this off. So there we go, gave me a little belly button there. I'm just going to bring this yarn tail up through the body, pull it through, pull on it slightly, and cut. And now the yarn tail has disappeared and buried inside the body. Okay, now we're going to assemble the arms, and I've just finished one here, and we're just going to carry the yarn up to the top of the sleeve. And don't pull it so tight that it alters the shape down here. Like if you pull on it, you can pull it right down. Don't do that. And if you do, just pull it back out. Just want it loosely in there. And then we're just going to tape the arm. And you can see I just tucked the finishing yarn tail inside the arm. And we're not stuffing the arm. We're just going to slide it inside. And there should be about four rows sticking out. One, two, three, four. And that includes that magic circle that we started off with. Okay, so now we're going to bring our yarn needle back into the sleeve. Just catch a post there, go back in, and go through the arm. You just have to go by feel. And come out somewhere else across the other side. And pull it through. And again, don't pull it so tight that it alters the shape of the sleeve. And if you pull it too tight, just pull it back out. Now we're going to do this a few times to make sure that the arm stays in there. So I'm going to go back in again, catching a post right there, or wrapping around a post, sorry. Go in to the arm, and I'm going to come out in the front here. Okay, now I'm going to go back in again, wrapping around a post, and I'm going to go to the other side. Pull it through. Going back in. And once you do this a few times, then all you want to do is just pull on the arm. And if it doesn't come out, then it's in there good. Okay, once you have the arm all sewn in, just bring the yarn. You want to determine what's going to be the outside. So you can see this little dip here. You want that on the inside so you don't see that. So you want that facing the body. So this will be the outside of the arm. So I'm just going to bring my yarn needle across the other side, and then I'll leave it there until it's ready to be sewn on the doll. And you want it a little bit on the high side. There we go. Okay, so now you want to decide if you want to add in a thumb. Now this little guy has no thumbs, and this one does. And either way is just fine, and it's totally up to you. Okay, so adding the thumb is pretty simple. We're just going to go right through here. Just push the crochet hook right through the stitch, just like that. And bring in the color you used for the arm and pull it through. Get ready to crochet. Okay, and now just chain one. And now we're going to put in two double crochets. And a double crochet, you just yarn over before going into the stitch. So just yarn over. And then we're just going to go in. We're going to push our crochet hook through, just like we did here, one row over. Grab your yarn, pull it through. You have three loops on your hook. Grab your yarn and pull it through the first two loops. Grab your yarn and pull it through the last two loops. And that was a double crochet. And now we're going to go into the same stitch we just put that one in and do it again. So yarn over, go in, grab your yarn, pull it through. You have three loops. Yarn over, pull through the first two. Yarn over and pull through the last two. And now you're done. So we're just going to cut free. Pull the yarn tail through that loop and pull it tight. So now all we have to do now is just shape the thumb a little bit. So we're just going to thread the first yarn tail here. So now we want to bring the double crochets over, just fold it over, just like that. So we're just going to bring the yarn needle right underneath and come up through there. And now let's take the other yarn tail. And you can just go over and I just closed up that edge there. Bring this down and out through a stitch hole. Now if you're happy with the shape of the thumb, then you can just bring the yarn tails out through the same stitch hole there. As long as they're coming through the same stitch hole, you can knot them together. And before you do that, just make sure you're happy with how the thumb is looking, and I think that looks pretty cool. So we'll just knot these two off. Cut them up a bit shorter. And then I'm just going to push that into the arm. Okay, so the one thumb is on and all done. And so when you do the other one, just make sure you do the same steps, but just make sure it's folding in the other way. So when you put them on, they're facing each other. So now I'm going to fuzz up the end of the tail, just like this guy here. And again, you don't have to do that. It's optional and it's totally up to you. There's different tools that you can use. An old stiff toothbrush would work fine. This is a nail brush, and I was just trying it here. Now, it will work. It's going to take a while. See, it fuzzes it up a little bit. So this might be a bit too soft. And I have, this is an old pet brush, a steel pet brush. And this here is called a nap razor, and it's meant for doing, raising the fibers on yarn. So, and you can see the pet brush, the bristles are the exact same. So this works great. And now you have to be careful when you use something like this. It's very aggressive. So when you put it on there, you could end up potentially putting a hole into your stuffy. So you got to just make sure that you keep the brush moving and you're not just in one spot. Just keep it moving. And when I put the bristles on, I'm pulling up in the direction of the bristles. So you can see they're going in a direction there. So I put it on and pull up. And then you can see it does pull the stuffing through sometimes. So you can just pull that off, or you can even leave it in there. It doesn't really matter. So there, the tail is done. And that didn't take me very long with that aggressive pet brush. An old stiff toothbrush will work, but it'll just take you longer. So, and if you see a little bit of stuffing has been pulled through, just go around and kind of pull it out. It'll come out very easy. So there you have it. And I didn't stuff this part of the tail. Okay, so for the horn part, I will walk you through the first two rows of that part because it is a small round that we start off with. And I know a lot of people that are just starting out find that part a little bit difficult. So you make your magic ring or adjustable loop with 5 stitches. And now we're going to put 1 single crochet in each one of those 5 stitches. So what I found is as you're crocheting in a small tiny round, the work will start closing up on itself and you need to stop and turn it right side. So we're going to do that together. So 1 single crochet in the first, 1 single crochet in the second, it's already starting to fold, 1 single crochet in the third, 1 in the fourth. So we're at 4 now, and you can stop, you could stop at 3 or 4, pull out that last stitch so you don't lose it, and turn the work inside out, or right side out, sorry. So just push where that starting tail is coming out of, push that inwards. And this part too, some people might find it easier if they switch to a smaller hook just to get the first couple of rounds done. So we need to put 1 more single crochet in the next stitch. So that was 1 single crochet in the fifth, and there we're done the second row. And for this starting yarn tail, you can cut it up a bit shorter to get it out of your way. So you can just take that and just push that inside. And now it's out of your way. So now you can continue on. Okay, so I just finished stuffing 1 horn, and all I do is just bend the tip over. And I'm using a back end of a pencil to stuff the horn. So just get your stuffing in there. You don't want to overstuff the very tip, or otherwise you'll see stuffing showing through. So just stuff a little bit in the tip first of all, and then get the rest in there. Okay, now we're going to start sewing the doll together. And I like to start with the legs first. I put the legs on first. And you can see here how I put them on and the shape of them. Now when you first finish the legs off, they don't have that shape. They kind of look like this. But if you remember where we crocheted in the back loops, if you just push this bottom part inwards, it gives you a basket-like bottom, a flat bottom, and then you have that edge. And it sits nicely like that. That's why we crocheted in the back loops there. And then I'm just going to stretch out the legs to the sides, just to give it a little bit of shape and help it maintain its shape. There we go. Now we're going to stuff these, and you're also going to pin them in place, and lots of pins. And use lots of pins. Now you don't want to overstuff the legs, because that'll make them bulge out. You just want to stuff them enough to keep its shape. That will do. I'm going to pin them in place. Now there's the front, the belly button's the front. And I'm going to pin these on with the yarn tails hanging out the back. And I want to make sure that I have them right centered. There's enough space on each side. There's an even amount of space. Okay, right there. So I'm going to stick my pins in. Things like this tend to move about when you're sewing them in, so the more pins the better. And you'll notice I'm going in on a slant as well, so I can sew around the bottom and I won't be hitting the pin itself. Okay, so we're going to bring the first stitch right down into that body, as close to the leg as you can get it, and then just come out somewhere away from that area. Come through a stitch hole. Now going back in the same hole you just came out of, go back in and go up and underneath the leg. You can see my needle there. I'm going to go underneath and through the bottom edge of the stitches. And now back down into the body, right close to the leg, in and out. Back in the same stitch hole I just came out of, up and underneath, inside, and through a stitch hole on the leg. I'll just keep repeating those steps all the way around to the one leg is sewn in. Okay, I just finished the second leg. Now I'm going to bring this yarn tail out to where the other one is hanging, and I'm going to come out the same stitch hole, just pull it through. Now if you've pulled anything while you were stitching the legs in and anything here looks a little bit odd, just reach in and pull it back out, because sometimes when you stitch in things that way and you bring the yarn tail out away from the thing you're stitching and then you go back in, you can cause a hole or make something pull in where it shouldn't be. So just reach in and pull it back out. And that fixes that. Now these two yarn tails are coming out the same stitch hole now, so I'm just going to knot them. I'm going to cut them up a bit shorter, and then I'm just going to push that into the body. Okay, now we're going to sew the arms on, and I got one done already, and I brought the yarn tail out through a stitch hole in the back, and I'll leave it hanging there, and I'll notch it off with this one when I'm all done. So just place it on like so, and we're going to bring the yarn, the first stitch, just down into the body and come out through the back through a stitch hole. Then we can go back in the same hole we just came out of. Go in and underneath and grab the arm there. See, I'm going right through. You can come right through a stitch hole on the arm. If you come through the top of the arm like that, just make sure you go back in the same hole you came out of. So I'll go in and down into the body and out through a stitch hole. Now depending how much this is going to get played with, if it's going to get played with a lot, then you want to make sure you got a few stitches in there to make sure the arms are going to stay in place. If it's just going to sit on the shelf and be a shelf sitter, then you don't need that many stitches. But if you want a few more stitches, then just go back in the same hole you just came out of. Going in and come underneath the arm, go in, and this one you can just bring to the other side. Now you put in as many stitches as you need. So what I'm doing is I'm just sewing underneath the arm. The bottom edge of the arm is getting sewn to the body, so you don't see any of the stitches on the sides or on the outside of the arm. Okay, so that looks pretty good. And none of the stitches are showing on the outside. So just bring out the yarn tails out a same stitch hole, then you can knot them off. Okay, so now we're going to put the tail on. I've already got one stitch in there, so Just place it where you want it. Okay, and just do a series of whip stitches. I just go in and grab a row there. Come back up. There we go. So once it's all sewn in, you can just go to the bottom of the tail there, grab a stitch and knot this off. Bring the yarn tail up and away, pull on it slightly and cut. Now we're sewing the horns on, and you want to use lots of pins. And again, I put the pins in on a slant, so when I sew around the bottom edge, I don't hit the pins as I go around. So make sure that you're very happy with the placement of the horns before you start sewing, because once they're sewn in, the only way to remove them is cut them free. So you want to make sure that you have them exactly where you want them. And I've got the one done, and I brought a yarn tail out here, and I'm going to knot it off with the other one when I'm done. Okay, so again, lots of pins around, because it will move about as you're sewing if you don't have enough pins in there. So I'm just going to bring the first stitch down and come out somewhere away from the horn. Go back in the same hole I just came out of, and now I can come up underneath the horn. You can see my yarn needles up and underneath that horn. And I'm going to go through the bottom edge, the last row of stitches there. Pull it through. And remember, if you pull anything too tight and this looks like it's been dipped down, just go in and pull it back up. And I'm not pulling extremely tight on any stitches, I'm just pulling snug. Back in the same hole, go up and underneath, so now I'm underneath the horn again, and I'm going to come through the last row of stitches. So I'm just going to keep repeating these steps all the way around. Okay, now that our doll has been sewn together, we can add in the face, and this is my favorite part. What you have now is a blank slate, and you can do whatever you desire on your monster. These are just designs that my daughter and I came up with, and I'm just going to show you how to attach the teeth and how to do different parts to get the mouth to look the way it does. I'm also going to show you how to add in a nose if you want one, and how to attach buttons to a doll. So this is the original drawing from my daughter. So what I did was try to match it best I could. And she has some really great things going on here. And I want to do it as close as I can to the drawing. When we first found this drawing together, because this drawing is about 4 years old now, when we first found the drawing together, we went over it and she added parts like the tail. She asked me to add that in. And she also asked me to add in a nose. So that's what I did. And then my idea only was just the little bit of white behind the eyes, just to make the eyes pop out a bit more, because she actually drew on buttons, and I thought that was kind of cool. Okay, so what we're going to do first of all is you're going to decide what kind of eyes you want. I'm using buttons because that's what's in the drawing. Okay, so I have a needle that will go through the buttonhole, but if you don't have a needle that has a good size that will go through that, then I have a tutorial here on YouTube that will walk you through the steps of threading a button with some yarn. And you can get the yarn in those holes even though your needle doesn't fit. So just click that link and I'll show you how to do that. But right now I'm just going to use the needle that fits here. So I'm just going to, I went up from underneath and I want to crisscross it. And now I'm going to switch to my larger yarn needle here. This one I use for sewing amigurumi together, it works better. Okay, so now those are ready to be put on. Now, what I've done here is I've added felt behind just to make the eyes pop. So once you thread the button, the felt is going to be a little bit too big. So what I did was just cut a piece out of the middle there, so it'll fit in nicely behind there. But you don't need to put the felt in yet. Those can be glued in after. So I'm going to go ahead and I have a tutorial to walk you through putting a button on a doll, but I'm just going to show you here so you don't have to keep flipping back and forth. So I know where I want it, right about there. I'm just going to go in and come out the back side here. That was one, and I'm going to do the other one. So now I'm going to bring this yarn thread down one post over, so not through the same hole the first one's going. But when you come out the other side, come through the same hole that the first one's coming through. So in through a different hole and out through the same. There we go. I'm just going to leave those hanging for a minute. I'm just going to do this one here. Okay, so both of them have been put in. And you know, now that I'm looking at it, I'm thinking I might leave the felt off. I'm not sure yet. So I'm just going to leave those back here the way they are. I'm just going to cut them up a bit shorter so they're not in my way. I'll leave enough length that I can work with after, because I'm going to knot these together. But I'll just leave them hanging for now. Okay, and so the mouthpieces, this is really fun here. This is just red felt and then white felt, and these are just pieces that I cut to fit inside here, and these are just chains. And then there's the other one here. I'm going to actually do this one like the drawing, but just to show you how you can do different things, I'm going to show you what I did to make this guy here. So I'm going to thread my black yarn, and I'm just going to come up to this side here and put the mouth where I want it. Actually, I can double it up here. So I'm just going to go in and out through the side. And I'm going to leave it doubled so it's a little bit on the thick side there. I'm just going to cut this free though. Okay, and then I would take this one, this purple chain, and I'm going to bring one of the yarn tails right on the corner where the other one is. And bring it out through the side. And then the same for this one. So I've got a little bit of a different mouth there. And then I pre-cut these our square or rectangular teeth. And I think those are kind of cute. And so what I would do is just glue them right underneath this black piece here. Now this part is a little bit tedious. You have to go very slow because if you get glue on your doll, you will not get it off. So I'm going to show you that in a minute here, how I glue the pieces on. I'm just showing you temporary faces here. I lost a tooth. Oh, there it is. Okay, so there's another option. And then you can also take the same color as this top chain here. There, I gave him a mouth like this guy here, and then you can just play around with the teeth different ways. Just give him one tooth if you want. So, like I said, there's so many things that you can do with that blank slate that you've got right now. So take your time or get a child to draw you out a face and see what you guys come up with. Okay, so we're gonna assemble the face right here. So I'm gonna assemble this on film so you can see how I glue the pieces in. So I ended up finding some burgundy felt, so I'm gonna use that for the background instead of having the entire mouth red, and then that way I can add the tongue like she's done here. So she's got some red behind there, and then she outlined the tongue, so I think that will better match her photo. So I just used fabric tack and I glued the tongue piece on, and I used a pin just to give that little indent there. So now I'm doing the teeth. Okay, so I lost a clip of me gluing the teeth on, so I'll have to redo it here, but I'll just do two, save myself the time. So for the bigger teeth, I just ran a bead of glue along the top edge, just along the very edge of that tooth, and then I just laid that down. So the bottom of the tooth is not glued down, and it can stick out a little bit. And then the smaller teeth, I just ran a bead of glue along the edge of the bigger piece, just a small bead like that, and then I just laid the smaller teeth on top. This is a big tooth, but I'll just use it. And then just laid the edges down on top. And once that's dry, they stay in there really, really well. And then after, you'll be gluing these pieces down, and that holds them even more. And then once I have all the teeth on, then I just glued the entire piece down where I wanted it. And when you do the glue, make sure, I'll show you here, when you get the glue on there, spread it out with the tip of your glue bottle so there's no big globs. Because when you push this down, you don't want any glue oozing out. You want it to stay on the felt itself and not come oozing out anywhere. Okay, I just pin the chains in. So I'm just going to bring the first one. And make sure when you make the chains that you have a long enough tail on each end that you can use to sew in. It's better to be too long than too short. Okay, I'm going to do the other one now. I'm just doing the top chain first. Those pins can come out of there. And now I'm going to do, whoops, leave that there. And I'll do the bottom ones now. Okay, so you can take one of the yarn tails and sew this down, or you could use fabric tack. Now again, I can't stress this enough, if you get the glue anywhere outside of the mouth, it's going to look horrible. So you got to go very, very slow and just use a little tiny bit, because a little bit goes a long way. This is fabric tack. You don't need very much. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to glue mine in. I'm just going to place it right underneath the chain. So I'm just going to roll the chain over, and I'm just going to put a little dot. I roll it back. I'm just going to do a little section at a time. Okay, adding the teeth for this guy here was a whole lot simpler and took less time. I'm just going to show you in the back side here. I went in and I made the mouth, the black part first. Okay, and then I took my teeth and I figured out how I wanted them placed on here. Now just raise up, pull up the mouth a bit. Leave the yarn tails hanging the way they are and just pull the mouth up so it's loose. Figure out how you want the teeth. where you want to put them, okay? And then you just run glue along the very edge of the tooth, and you just hold up the black yarn and put the tooth underneath and then press it down. And once you have all your teeth in, you just pull the sides of the yarn until it's nice and snug. And then once all that's on, then you just take your chain and put it over top and sew it in, put the corners in first, just like I did on this one here. And then you can roll it back and put a little tiny bit of glue along the edge and roll it back down. And then you'll have that mouth just like this guy here. Okay, so it's all down. I think that looks pretty cool. And pretty much like her drawing. Yeah, it looks pretty cool. So what I did with the eyes was I did glue down the felt underneath, and then I actually added a little dot of glue behind the buttons themselves, and those buttons will not go anywhere now. They're staying there for good. So now I'm just going to knot these off, all these yarn tails here. Okay, and I'm just gonna cut them all up a bit shorter. And then push them all inside. If you see any the black ones when you put them in, sometimes you can see them through a stitch hole. So I'll go over about 3 stitches down and just grab it and push it around until you can't see it anymore. But you can leave it without a nose, or you can add one. And adding a nose, all I did was, I did the same thing I did for the thumbs. I just added in a couple double crochets. So I'm going to go where I want to put the nose at, right in the middle there. Pull the yarn through. Make sure that you have a length. The beginning starting tail there has a length that you can work with later that you can sew in. Okay, and it's chain one. Okay, now I'm going to do a couple double crochets here. I'm going to yarn over before I go in, and I'm actually going to go in the very same stitch I just pulled the yarn through, because I'm right in the middle there. Pull it through. Now you have 3 loops. Yarn over, pull through the first 2. Yarn over and pull through the last 2. Now we can stop there, or you can put more in if you'd like. I'm just going to make it a little nose. Pull the yarn tail through the loop. Now we're just going to shape the nose a little bit. I'm just going to bring this one yarn tail up and out of the way. And I'll use the other one to shape the nose. So let us go into a stitch underneath and pull it through. And I think that's good just like that. So I'm going to leave it just like that. So I'll bring this other yarn tail out through here. I'll knot them off. So that was easy. So that's the end of that tutorial. I hope you had fun, and I hope you got yourself a little monster made. Thanks so much for watching, and see you soon!